actually ends up making it.
Oh. Okay.
Like, I need to give you mine.
Okay, I'm going to call the meeting to order. It is 4:02. Commissioner Ryan will join us. Roll call, please.
Mayor Crawford.
Here.
Commissioner Blanchard.
Here.
Commissioner Davis.
Here.
Commissioner Hardy.
Here.
Commissioner Ryan.
Here.
Okay. I see there are some Boy Scouts in the room, and I thought maybe you would like to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance and moment of silence. Would you like to lead us? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I don't believe we have any awards and proclamations today. Citizens Forum, if there's anyone here who would like to come up and address the commission for 3 minutes on anything that is not on the agenda, this is the time to do that. Okay, hearing or seeing none, mm-hmm. We'll go on to item five.
Okay. Oh, these are mine.
Item 5.1, public hearing and report on petition number 4383, requesting the vacation of a 10-foot wide north-south alley that abuts lots 1 and 3 on 7th Street and lots 2 and 4 on Santa Fe in the original town of Salina, Saline County, Kansas, to allow lots 1 and 3 and lots 2 and 4 to be merged into a single building lot. 5.1A, first reading ordinance number 16-10867.
Okay, I'm going to open the public hearing and ask staff for a report.
Thank you, Mayor and Commissioners. This is a petition that was filed by Troy Reinert on behalf of Kansas Properties LLC. And the property in question is part of the original town of Salina that was laid out in 1862. It runs from North Street on the north to South Street on the south. This area is characterized by 50 by 120 foot lots, and each of the blocks in the original town is bisected by a 10 foot north-south alley. And the particular property we're talking about here is at the corner of Santa Fe and North Streets, and it is separated from the rest of the original town by some railroad right-of-way that runs through here. What we have is a situation where Kansas Properties owns property on both sides of this alley right here, and they would like to create a single building lot there. And in review by city staff, we determined that there had been no record of that alley being vacated. So in response to that, they have filed this petition. It's been reviewed by city staff and by potentially affected utilities. And there is no public purpose to the alley in terms of vehicle access or as a utility corridor. So as the alley no longer serves any public purpose, it's our recommendation that the attached ordinance ordering the vacation of the alley between 7th and Santa Fe, south of North Street, be approved on first reading. With that, I'd be open to any questions that you might have.
Okay. Are there any questions, Mr. Andrew?
If not, thank you.
Okay, public comment. Is there any public comment on this public hearing and petition 4383? Okay.
Madam Mayor, I move.
Okay. I close the public hearing.
Madam Mayor, I move that we approve on first reading ordinance number 16-10867,
ordering the vacation of the platted alley between North 7th Street and Santa Fe. Ordering the vacation platted of the platted alley between North 7th Street and Santa Fe. Be approved.
Second.
Okay, there's a motion and a second to pass ordinance 16-108-67 on first reading. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
And those opposed, same sign. Okay.
Madam Mayor, before we get started here on your consent agenda, I have a couple of packets that were left at my station.
Well, I have those too.
These are all the same thing.
Well, I don't know. I think I have those too.
I got one of them.
You want to take a look at these and see if they're...
I don't know whether you're supposed to think I have.
I got that one. I got that one. What's that? Is there one of the letter?
Sure, what?
Or something.
Oh, okay. All right, everyone got that one then?
Officially.
Okay.
Yeah.
There's a memorandum, but this will be later.
Oh.
Use it later, so everyone knows the copy of this letter.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you.
There's enough of these to...
Something new. Does the clerk need one of these?
Okay. We're on item 6, consent agenda.
Item 6.1, approve the minutes of October 3rd, 2016. Item 6.2, approve the reallocation of sub-CIP funds and purchase one Stryker ambulance performance load COT securing device. Item 6.3, authorize proposal from Qualite Sports Lighting LLC utilizing Heineken Electric to upgrade the lighting on fields number 3 and number 4 at the East Crawford Recreation Area.
Is there anything on the consent agenda that anyone like to, any commissioner would like to have pulled? If not, I'll accept a motion on approval of the consent agenda.
Madam Mayor, I move we approve the consent agenda as presented.
Second.
I have a motion and a second to approve the consent agenda. All those in favor say aye.
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 Those opposed, same sign. Okay. We're down to administration.
Item 7.1, first reading ordinance number 16-108-66, levying Salina Business Improvement District number 1 service fees for 2017.
Michelle.
Thank you, Mayor and Commissioners. Kind of timely since you just had a study session that related to SDI. But this is related to the BID fees in Business Improvement District Number 1, which is the downtown area that was formed in 1983. And every year, based on a recommendation from the BID board, who is also the SDI board, we come before you to ask for any changes in fees because they have to be adopted through an ordinance. For 2017, the BID board requested an increase of 2.5%. in their fee rate, and the ordinance before you incorporates those fees. Per state statute, they do have to be adopted by ordinance. Anybody have any questions about the fees?
Any questions?
Is that 2.5% increase, is that the same as last year, or is that, I know there were a number of years that there was really no increase. Is that the same increase as last
there was
year?
Yes, there was a 2.5% increase from 15 to 16.
Okay. Do you anticipate it being that 2.5? Are we trying to get to a certain level and then it'll be maybe a lesser increase or?
Not really. The purpose of that is that in time you don't want the fees to fall so far behind that they really can't address the service needs that you have and that SDI has when they kind of implement this on behalf of the Business Improvement District. So it's just not to fall too far behind. It's the same concept that you have asked staff to do, which is when we look at our annual fees to try to at least sort of keep them close to inflationary increases each year. So that's why we continue to bring you to 2.5%, somewhere in there.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Michelle. Any public comment? Do I have a motion on pass ordinance number 161-0866?
I move that we approve on first reading ordinance number 16-10866, levying Salina Business Improvement District number 1 service fees for 2017.
Second.
I have a motion and a second to pass ordinance 161-0866. An ordinance levying Salina Business Improvement District number 1 service fees for 2017. All those in favor say aye.
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 Opposed, same sign. 7.2.
Item 7.2, resolution number 16-7394, providing for the advisability and authorization related to establishing special improvement district for water, sanitary, sewer, street, and drainage improvements in Grand Prairie Edition Phase 2.
Mr. Stack.
Thank you, Madam Mayor and Commissioners. This is a continuing item from August, I guess actually September 19th, I believe. And we were asked to look at the agreement and add some language into it about contractor warranties, performance and payment bonds, and the city's right to inspect the basically the auditing of the records for the project. And so we had to postpone it. At that time, we hadn't quite worked through that language with Gilmore and Bell, which is our bond counsel. And we have done that mostly now. We talked with them this morning on just a little bit more of the language. The final version of this agreement is in your packet. And I tried to put the red line version in there to show what we changed. So I guess that was the part about contractor warranties, performance bonding, and auditing of it should be in there, and is that actually should be pretty, we're not going to change that at this point. There's nothing, we don't believe anything needs to be changed there. There is some clarification we'd like to add to the reimbursement language, and that is, it's not, I don't believe it's inaccurate the way it is, it's just we couldn't figure out exactly what it meant, so it was an interesting discussion where we all had to think, okay, how does this really work out with the reimbursement? So we figured out that we need to explain it better so that we and ourselves and anybody else who reads this can remember it in the future, and so we're going to propose some language for that, and so we're going to bring this back to you next week. So I guess we're just asking today to postpone this. The developer also had some questions on some of the language in here for reimbursement, so we felt like, okay, one more week isn't going to hurt him, and he wanted to get it done soon, but another week would help us. So I guess we can talk about any of the red line stuff you'd like to today, or we can talk about it more next week. So what would you like to do? Any more questions on it
questions?
So far?
No. Appreciate the look at those, though. I like those. And I have to admit that 3 reimbursement B, I don't know if that's the part you're referring
that's
to, but
one.
It's a little
yes.
confusing. So
it is, yes. We're going to try and clear that up.
Okay.
Yeah, basically we're trying to make sure, based on the guidance from the commission on 80%. So we got to figure out what is going to be 80% and 80-20 split. And so when you have all these different construction, you have interest, you have other bond issuance, you have other things in there, and so we have to, the math actually works, but try to explain a little bit better.
Mm-hmm.
So that's our goal for the next time, a week from now, as well as just making sure the developer's got to sign this and he's got to understand it as well. So I guess at this point would ask that you postpone it for one more week to the what the date is next week. That'd be the 24th.
Any of the red lined stuff or
okay. Thank you.
Need a motion then to postpone this to a date
we postpone consideration of resolution number 16-7394 until October 24th, 2016.
A motion and a second to postpone resolution number 16-7394 to October 24th, 2016. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. And opposed, same sign. Okay. 7.3, please.
Item 7.3, resolution number 16-7404. Authorizing the artwork design and fabrication contract for the Salina Fieldhouse project.
Good afternoon, Mayor and Commissioners. Thanks for taking the time to review your weekend reading. and to not read you again, I'll go through the highlights of what's being presented for you today and then stand for questions. We've also got some additional illustrations if you require them. This is an agreement that formalizes a relationship between the city, the artist, and the fabricator for an integrated art element for the new field house. Salina Arts and Humanities, along with city staff, project designers, architects, contractors, and the site committee, have identified an area with the highest impact and function that integrates the building aesthetics to a sculptural element, which also functions as a necessary shading device. The site committee is comprised of Salina Arts and Humanities staff, Salina Parks and Rec staff, an owner's rep, downtown residents and business owners, related community members from SDI and Visit Salina, and private financial stakeholders, as well as the project architect and a community art and design advisory committee member. The design guidelines were included in your packet and are used to help inspire the artist who's already made a site visit and attended planning meetings with the architect and fabricator. The surface selected for the designs is a brushed stainless steel surface with aluminum and or steel supports behind those panels. The bid package that has been presented today includes all the necessary hanging and installation hardware anticipated for the project. The fabricator, Zahner, is a globally recognized company who's completed projects for museums, sports coliseums, airports, community buildings, and many other highly visible businesses. Jeremy Rockwell is a qualified designer from the Lawrence and Kansas City area who met with the site committee and was approved as a direct selection artist to work on this project. Little side note, based on the timeline, accelerated timeline, a compressed time that we wanted to work efficiently with construction deadlines and proposals and to have things meet, being able to use a direct selection process of a qualified designer who was also in proximity to both Salina and Zahner was very helpful. If approved today, the site committee will review the preliminary designs provided by the artist, offer suggestions to have them refined into a single recommended design, and then we'll present that proposed solution to the City Commission in a study session scheduled in November. The budgetary considerations for today include $119,634 for a fabrication and design agreement. Other elements such as footings, installation labor by contractors, and electrical service to the space are already included in the approved construction bid. Sometimes, and I don't know that any commissioners sitting today were here during some previous projects, but sometimes the project was designed and then the footing was stipulated later in to receive the piece as it was conceived. In this case, a preliminary concept with the partnership of the architects and contractors was done so that a responsible bid could be prepared for that footing as part of the building design, and so that's been accomplished. Specific recommendations and costs for lighting fixtures will be determined once the design is approved. The overall project will be below the not to exceed amount provided by the commission of $175,000. We anticipate being below that. We also anticipate that this solution will provide a dynamic and functional sculptural element that complements the overall design of the building. It will send a message that Salina is a progressive community that appreciates beauty and design excellence. And as mentioned earlier, Salina Arts and Humanities will make a preliminary presentation of the recommended artistic design from the site committee and community art and design advisory committees to this body in November, followed by a formal presentation to the city commission at least 1 week following that study session or with whatever time is necessary for that. So I think I'll leave it at that and stand for questions.
I guess, does anyone have any questions?
Nope.
I just wondered if it was a standing work of art or if it's gonna be on the building. I guess I don't.
John, since John agreed to stand by at the ready, let's go ahead and pull up that PDF of the site, the first PDF that's in the row that I think says freestanding. It's actually going to be composed of three different elements. Outside the building that faces the west, where the windows are along the concourse area, and the entryway into the gymnasiums that are along that north-south run, basically facing the parking lot where Blue Sky and the new medical center are going to be. What you see here is about 120 feet of run, and that doesn't include the spaces in between. But these are perforated, freestanding metal panels. So excited to have a pointer and it doesn't work. right over there. Anyway, those are freestanding panels with the, thank you, that are 10 feet in height. The total length of the panels, and again, not to include these spaces in between, is 120 feet. These are approximately 4 feet wide on each of those. Those will be perforated with a design. That design has yet to be determined, but the method of which the surface will be treated has been determined. These are some examples of how perforation occurs, and that can be both illustrative, creating an image, it could create a pattern, it could create a combination of image and pattern, and that's work that the site committee and community art and design advisory committee will be doing. Zahner has a patented process that shows, cuts through those steel panels. It's very low maintenance. It's going to be a beautiful surface that I think will complement the building well. There are two other places, Mayor, that the pieces will go besides these freestanding columns. Then just at the entryway of the building, there will be two panels on the outside of the building and three on the inside of the building. And so as you pass through the glass entryway, that design will continue, and elements of the design along the long wall will be articulated in some fashion to build continuity with that. And there'll be one additional panel in a skylight above the entryway when you come in. So at night, the pattern looks much like you see here in a perforated, and again, this is representative of another image, nothing like what you may see in a few weeks. But if you do imagine that everything you see in this design that's dark, at night will be light, and the rest of the surface will be dark. It's going to be backlit with broad flood lighting then that reverses the pattern.
Stainless steel. So that
stainless steel. Brushed stainless steel.
It ought to be pretty.
Yes. It's a beautiful and durable surface that I think will complement and pick up some of the color that's around the area as well. So are there additional questions?
So this would be, I know part of the design was to block sunlight, the setting sun.
Correct. Keep light from streaming through the windows and in onto the courts and heating up the other space that's there. So light will still transfer through to a point, but it works like a shade.
Okay, is there some degree of visibility of the inside lobby from the sidewalk with these up, or is that going to be fairly totally blocked?
That has yet to be determined depending on the concentration of the perforations that are done and the ultimate design. Some of the designs that are done show large areas that aren't perforated and others that are, and then others that might have a large concentration that are. It should provide much like a diffusing shade on a window. What it should do is prevent the significant sunlight from coming into the court or to the hallway area that was of concern. And so, and in terms of integrated art and design, mm-hmm. if Grace and the site committee, our visual arts coordinator and community art and design staff member Grace Peterson is here also and can answer questions about the site committee if you have any. But they looked at different possibilities, everything from the skin of the building in certain areas to what other needs were that were identified by the architect. And if these panels weren't done, then some other kind of interior or exterior shading device or canopies or louvers or something were going to have to be done to allow light to enter. The other thing that if you see where the break is, you could probably, I'm speculating here, Commissioner, but if there's a window directly behind one of those series of panels, you can look to the left or look to the right and see through those open areas that don't have panels. So it will be a continuous design that runs through those, but it isn't a solid wall. So
they're 8 foot tall.
Ten feet tall.
Mm-hmm.
These are 10 feet in height and approximately 4 feet wide.
And what does it look like from the inside of the building? What does the back of this look like if you're inside the field house?
The steel armature, we don't have preliminary designs for. That would be the next phase on the approval here, but there are vertical steel struts that you may need to come up here to answer that.
A superstructure that Zahner is designing specifically for our project so that it'll be as seamless as possible. But to answer your question, it'll look like the reverse of what you're seeing on the other side. I mean, it's basically going to look very similar to the front.
So you still see the design from the...
Yes, you
okay.
will. And then you'll be able to see light through that during the day, and at night it won't be lit from the... you know, front side. So it'll be more spectacular from the street at night, and you'll be able to appreciate on both sides during the day. So.
All right.
I'll just say that I know one of the things that was important here was to say if you could try to incorporate design and functional elements to achieve that. It looks like you've done that, so without going too much into what those perforations are going to come together to look like. I think that you've achieved that in the sense that you're providing a functional use with a bit of a aesthetic to it that I think will both look good both in day and night. So. And drastically different between the two times of day.
Yes, and we do. I think there's a real value and benefit for everyone to have something that is included early in the design and fabrication process with the architect so that we can design footing spaces and impact and have a positive impact. There were things like canopy covers outside if there was going to be an outdoor picnic area or a shield area for people driving in depending on what the footprint of entering and leaving the facility would be. At one point it was just replacing the metal skin that's already been approved in terms of color design at the early stages. It was, could the art do that? And based on the size, the scale, the timeline, those were all functional applications that could have happened, but this was an identified need that didn't have a better solution and a good and cost-effective use of the materials. So yeah, I think you'll have a very nice design to consider that's reflective of the design guidelines that were provided both by staff and the committees to help inform the artist. So
thank you.
Any public comment?
back up here.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I move we approve resolution number 167404 to authorize the artwork design and fabrication contract for the Salina Fieldhouse project.
Second.
I have a motion and a second to approve resolution 167404 regarding a contract for the Salina Fieldhouse project. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. And those opposed, same sign. Okay. We're on to 7.4.
Item 7.4, Fieldhouse naming discussion of options.
Okay, Mayor and Commissioners, I'll quickly take you down memory lane. see where you go from there. As you recall, we had a request for naming of the field house through a philanthropic naming as part of our facility naming process. And it was presented a couple weeks ago, and it included naming the gymnasiums, I believe the lobby, the concession area, there may be a couple other places inside, but also included naming the outer, the building itself on the outside. That naming recommendation came through your Parks and Rec Advisory Board, who did their part, as we typically like to have an advisory board sort of help vet questions and details and so forth. So this item went through that as part of the policy and the process, and they recommended approval for the naming that was presented. The naming on the outside of the building was originally a Salina Regional Health Center Community Field House, but I think in time with discussions and kind of a look at the graphical space and all that, it came back as in the large letters horizontally across the top of the naming area. It was Salina Field House, and then in quite a bit smaller letters, and you had the logo of Salina Regional Health Center, and then it would say Salina Regional Health Center, and that was tied to a $1.25 million contribution towards the project, as well as the other names were also tied to significant contributions to the project. At the last meeting, there was a lot of questions, I think, hopefully that were answered, but questions asked and answered, a lot of discussion. And in the end, the final issue seemed to be whether or not the main words of Salina Fieldhouse should have the word downtown inserted in between Salina and Fieldhouse. That was where you last left it. As you recall, there was a motion for Salina Fieldhouse. Well, there's a motion for the recommendation, the graphical recommendation of Salina Fieldhouse and underneath Salina Regional Health Center. And then there was an amended motion that was presented to include downtown that failed on a 2-2, and then it came back to the main motion, which also failed on a 2-2. And I can't help but think that you just didn't quite, the two groups of two didn't quite know where the other were going, but I don't know, we'll find out. So with that, what we have done is Greg Bingson, our legal counsel, Clark Mize and Linville, has prepared a memorandum that sort of outlines your option. And real quickly, you have the first option that you probably have at your disposal would be a motion to reconsider. He'll talk about that here in just a minute. You also potentially have a motion to add an item to your agenda, and that depends on what you do with your reconsideration, if in fact there is a motion to do that. And then there could be also an option to divide the resolution, which is not one that you've used before. So those probably take a little bit of introduction. But our thought is if you do leave this where you or begin this where you left it with the last meeting, that your real issue at this point would be whether you want to put downtown in between Salina and Fieldhouse. But certainly that's up to you. With that, I'll transition the item over to Mr. Bingson, and he can talk about your three options and potentially also possible questions that Commissioner Davis may have with regards to his participation.
Thank you. I think Mr. Gage has laid that out completely. The only thing I might add is that, as you would be aware under your rules, any possibility of a motion to reconsider would need to be here at today's meeting. It would no longer apply after today. And as you know, you certainly do have the ability to place a matter on your agenda at any time. Future agenda, as you might recall, it takes a majority vote. If you were to want to consider the matter today, that a motion to add any part of the matter to your agenda could occur if you attain the extraordinary four-vote majority necessary to do that. The Mr. Gage made reference to that motion to divide the resolution. I had mentioned that, particularly in light of Commissioner Davis's circumstances, and as you all know, but to anyone that might be observing or listening, that was a function of Commissioner Davis in his role as Dr. Davis, being employed by Salina Regional Health Center. That is a statutory substantial interest that, in the case of a contractual matter, which we felt as the discussion developed last week that we were in that area, that precluded his participation. That, of course, would only relate to the Salina Regional Health Center component of the matter. So there is a recognized principle in parliamentary procedure that would allow you to what is referred to as dividing the resolution or dividing the question in a way that, the Salina Regional Health Center aspect could be sufficiently isolated and the others dealt with separately in a way that would allow Commissioner Davis's participation. So with that, I want to see if you had any questions or where you might like to go with the matter, if at all.
Commissioners, one more thing I'd like to add, as well as one of the things staff looked at is we recognize that if you did add any word between Salina and Fieldhouse, it extends the size of the sign fairly significantly horizontally, and we wanted to find out what a potential cost range might be. And our staff has gotten with the designers, and what the impact of that would be. When you look at the Fieldhouse design, you have a certain pattern of colored panels, vertical panels, on most of the building at the upper level. Behind the sign, you'll see that the panels are the same color, so if you extend, we'll have to purchase additional metal panels, in essence a skin of the outside, to cover whatever area that the widened sign might need. The sign itself would be quite a bit larger, and then they would have the structural supports behind the sign, the whole design would have to be addressed, as well as the design to do all those things. So there'd be some design costs associated with those three things. And what we asked for is, we knew we couldn't get an exact cost in that period of time, but we asked for sort of a up to or a range, and what they said was up to $30,000. So I would say you're probably in a $20,000 to $30,000 range. It's probably still pretty broad, but what I wanted to do is be sure to know if it, because I thought it'd be important to you, whether it was a $2,000 to $3,000 or $3,000 or $4,000 or $5,000 issue or a fairly significant issue. You can determine in your mind what's significant, but I would say $20,000 to $30,000 is probably what you would be looking at for by adding a fairly large word and widening that sign. So I wanted to let you know that, and also that you may also choose to see if anyone here that's in attendance from the public may have any input at any time. It's a possibility that they might, just to be aware of that. So thank you.
So the first step, if we want to reconsider this, is to add it to the agenda.
There are the two approaches. The motion to reconsider would have to be by motion of either Mayor Crawford or Commissioner Blanchard, in that they voted on the prevailing side in that last action. Depending on whether they have interest in pursuing that or not, would then take you to your point that the other option is whether just to add it to the agenda, whether today with the extraordinary majority or by simple majority for a future date.
Okay, I want to make a motion to reconsider.
And I'll the second doesn't have to come from the other prevailing party, does it?
That's correct. Any commissioner may second that motion.
Question of the parliamentarian is this a vote of the entire board to reconsider, or only the original voters?
This would, given the nature of the matter and the inclusion of the Salina Regional Health Center aspect in the matter, I would have to recommend that Commissioner Davis not participate in the vote to reconsider. It simply takes the majority, but it would be just among the four participants.
And the motion is not debatable?
That's my understanding, that is non-debatable.
I have a motion to reconsider. I don't have a copy of the resolution yet.
You do.
I don't. Huh?
Well,
I don't.
We have the minutes, don't we?
I've got a whole bunch of these, but I don't have.
You should have the full packet up there. That was the instruction.
Here it is. He had, I don't have one. I have a motion to reconsider resolution 1674-03. All those in favor say aye.
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 Those opposed, same
aye.
Sign. I said aye.
3-1.
3-1. That
yes.
So that
has the effect of taking you right back to the point at which the previous vote occurred, as though the motion to adopt resolution 1674-03 as it was presented at your last meeting and voted upon is you're right back at the point before the prior vote was taken.
Before the amendment? Vote on the amendment?
No, the amendment fails.
The amendment was disposed of,
okay.
So to speak.
Okay.
And the last action you took was the vote on the main motion.
Main motion.
On the resolution. So we're back to the point of where that, where previously the two-two vote occurred.
Mm-hmm.
And because you're back to that point, certainly the main motion is still subject to amendment. It would be subject to division if that was your wish. It's just as though you have the main motion before you once again.
And discussion?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And discussion.
Well,
okay.
I think we should divide the motion so that Dr. Davis can participate in it as much as he can. So my thinking is that we would maybe amend this motion and divide the court naming portion of it away from the front of the building consideration. And then I think I'd like to see us divide the if you want to call it the municipal naming, separate from the philanthropic naming as well. So that we consider that top line as one item and then the bottom line as another item. Then Dr. Davis can participate, as I'm understanding you, in two phases of that, and then the third that involves the hospital, he'd have to recuse himself.
That's correct.
Yeah.
So
if I'm in a position to make the amendment, make an amendment offer.
No, you are, and it the motion would be to divide the resolution, and then to describe as you have to a certain extent. But in the motion, you would want to describe the manner in which you are moving that the resolution be divided.
And I would guess Dr. Davis. Can he vote on the amendment or not? Just to know.
I don't believe so, given the fact that it still, as the matter stands, involves the Salina Regional component. So
I can leave and just come back later.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll call you.
Well, you could recuse yourself all the way, but I was just trying to keep you in as much as possible.
Okay.
Well, if this would fly with the others, then I would make the motion that we amend the resolution to divide it first into considering the naming of the courts, if that's the proper way to do it, the gifts and the philanthropic gifts for the inside of the building, and then into two more portions. One to consider the municipal naming of the building, and the third to consider the philanthropic naming of the front of the building.
Real quick, commissioners, just I want to be sure that the motion is pinpoint. And I'm looking at the way the names were divided right now, because you do have, of course, the outer building name, which was brought up. You have the lobby, a concourse, concessions, and then the south gym. In the three courts associated with the South Gym and the North Gym, and the three courts associated with the North Gym. All of those are pieces of the inside building, the areas that are named. So I want to make sure this may or may not actually be what Commissioner Ryan wanted to do, but I wanted to basically make sure that I mean, you mentioned the courts. I just want to be sure that you meant that your intent was to include the lobby, the concourse, the concessions, South Gym, the three courts, the North Gym,
that's
and the
correct.
Associated
everything
three courts.
That's correct. Everything but the face
okay.
of the building, because
we'll
I think
make
we're
sure
all
the
in
motion's
agreement
clear.
On all of the others except for
okay.
the
thank
front.
You.
a motion to amend the motion.
To divide the motion.
It's actually a,
to divide
the resolution is technically the term. It does require a second, and it is not subject to debate.
Second.
Is there a second? Okay.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. All those in favor say aye.
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 And those opposed? Same sign? Okay.
Very
now.
Good. So the divided question, the divided resolution is now before you. And I suppose in the order that they were identified, it would first address all but the exterior naming. Is that fair to say?
Can I ask a question of staff in regard to the philanthropic naming of the interior spaces? Call them interior, exterior. Have those been formalized in an application so that if this is acted upon, that those are, each individual space is given a name and that's that? And let me tell you why I ask, and that is that should a decision down the road exclude a philanthropic naming for the exterior of the building, how do we find room on the interior of the building for that naming right, if that's so the desire of the commission? Does that make sense?
I think so. this will actually prompt a question to Mr. Cotton, Parks and Recreation, because your packet has a list of the application for the outer building, which is probably what's prompting your question. And then the report mentions all the naming, but you don't see in your report a copy of the application for the indoor spaces.
Right.
Is that correct?
Yeah.
Right.
That's part of the part A of
right.
the question.
So
right.
we should have a copy of an application for the inside spaces, but that's, I'll send it over to Chris as in the form of a question.
From my understanding, all of the names, both of the exterior and the interior, have been laid out originally. And I don't have that application with me, but I have read through the file, and all of the donors have been assigned different places within the facility and the exterior, the different courts, the concession stand, and I believe out in the foyer as well. Does that answer your question?
Well, that does, but I mean, it's still, the dilemma still exists.
Mm-hmm.
If from the standpoint of, if a further action should say, no, that doesn't seem to be the agreement of the board, then we have probably, well, not probably, we have the largest donor that would be kind of left out of the any sort of naming of an interior or anything else.
Yeah, if you're, well, it depends on your options and your choices. If you wish to shuffle and you would like to shuffle, but you approve all the inside names as is, I would agree there aren't any real large spaces left to shuffle. No question about that. I think that gets back to whether you wish to shuffle or whether you're comfortable with the interior or inside names.
Maybe we should do the exterior first.
What's the commission's pleasure?
So we can withdraw the motion, I suppose, and then back up and reverse
well.
It.
Greg, do they have the flexibility without too much formalization to rearrange
the order?
Yeah, I was about to suggest that they.
Okay.
I think they can. Yes.
You can rearrange the order,
the
commissioners, if you'd like. You're not locked into the order, so if you wish to address the name on the outer portion of the building first, you're able to do that.
Let's just do that.
Okay. So,
would that be the municipal or the philanthropic component that you would be addressing first? And the only reason I ask is it as it relates
mm-hmm.
to
mm-hmm.
Commissioner Davis's participation.
I think the municipal part first, and then we'll go on to the philanthropic. Is that okay?
Medicare, which
does it matter, does it?
And let the mayor.
It doesn't matter here.
Do I need a motion on this?
Well, I think as long as
consensus?
If someone would like to make a motion as to the proposed order of consideration, that would, I suppose, make sure that you're all on the same page, if that's developing.
So we had a motion second voted to put it on. Do we need to formally take it off other than just withdrawing a motion because it's actually been voted on and discussion started? Do we need to table it? Can we table that item until after? Can I make a motion to table the decision on the interior philanthropic naming for later in the meeting? Can I place that on the table?
That works.
Okay. And then if I can get a second, okay.
Do we need it? Wait. We have to vote on that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. We have a motion and a second to place on the table for later in the meeting the naming of the inside of the philanthropic group. Right. Okay, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Okay, passed.
So which part are we considering now?
The municipal.
Face or
The municipal.
I think you had the municipal in the original order, so I think if we moved on to that next, we'd be in the proper order.
Okay,
so.
Municipal. Which doctor can participate.
Correct.
Yes.
Okay. Correct.
Question for staff. Is, since this wasn't divided out before, are we working off of the municipal naming being Salina Fieldhouse? Is that what the working application is?
We of course we didn't contemplate the splitting of the question, but I would say probably so. I think because there was a lot of conversation with a lot of thoughts regarding that portion of the name, and I'm going to look at Chris, but I imagine that made sense to our staff with regards to that portion of it, Salina Fieldhouse. The reason is that from a length perspective, it's not too long. It kind of rolls off. It does provide it highlights Salina in the name, which is really important, I think, as from a marketing perspective. And of course, there was quite a bit of conversation on the word fieldhouse, and we felt that it is a fieldhouse, and that's a good descriptor. So the short answer is I would say yes, even though that wasn't necessarily contemplated at that point in time.
Okay, the resolution names the downtown fieldhouse as Salina Fieldhouse. So
originally said Salina Fieldhouse, and where we got stuck was putting the name downtown in there.
Right, right. Okay, so we need a motion on that, do we?
However we want to name it.
I would move that. I would move that we adopt the name Salina Fieldhouse as the municipal part of the name of the new structure.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Is there any public comment? A motion and a second to name the fieldhouse Salina Fieldhouse.
Kay. Yeah, and just discussion up here. I think it was kind of, that was one of those things that kind of we did have a discussion of. And I know that prior to the meeting last time, the feedback that I got from people in the community was that they liked the name Salina Downtown Fieldhouse or Salina Community Fieldhouse. And I particularly, I was chuckling earlier because the way we described this was, is the resolution is for naming the downtown fieldhouse Salina Fieldhouse.
Right. Right. Yes.
So
that's what it says.
You do need to chuckle at that it's interesting that we would, why not just name the Salina Fieldhouse the Salina Fieldhouse?
Right.
But
anyway.
But I really think, and just to explain sort of, and in the time since we had that meeting 2 weeks ago, I've heard from even more people that had an opinion on the name and so on. And I had a few more people that were in favor of Salina Downtown Fieldhouse versus Salina Community Fieldhouse. And the main reasons that I got from people is that they liked that it was like whose it was Salina's, and where it was downtown, and what it is, it's a fieldhouse, as opposed to a rec center or anything else like that. So I just like that, you know, being that this was kind of put out there as a catalyst for downtown redevelopment, and you know, one of the things, and Mayor Crawford, this is something that I really think is kind of important, and that is that I really appreciate the initiative that you have taken to really kind of bring awareness to neighborhoods,
mm-hmm.
and starting to identify neighborhoods. And this is one of those things where I think downtown is everyone's neighborhood, and to identify this facility with a neighborhood, I think kind of kills two birds with one stone. And I like the way it rolls off the tongue, and I know when people talk about downtown field house, they're talking about not just the field house, but also the downtown. So I'm going to stick with, I'd like to see this thing as the Salina Downtown Field House.
I would agree strongly, because we're trying to brand downtown. Now, I'll give you an analogy. I think the official name of that big brown building that we have our basketball games in is called the Salina Bicentennial Center. But what do we all call it? The Bicenter. But the official name on the outside of that building is a much longer one. Even if the official name of this building is long, and the advertisements just say, they may just call it the Field House. I mean, people are talking about it colloquially, they may not even say Salina Field House. But I think this is the one chance to have its official name representative of what it is, where it is, and the area that we're trying to promote. Because the name will get shortened no matter what it is, and probably just be called Field House, just like we call Bicentennial Center the Bicenter.
I don't think we need to have the name downtown on the building in order for people to understand that it's downtown and the significance it plays to the people and the city of Salina. I think that it will be shortened, and if it's going to be shortened, you know, it doesn't really need to be on the building, and it's going to be an extra $30,000 to begin with. I think that for simplicity's sake, for marketing's sake, no one from Hayes, Kansas is going to be helped by knowing that it's the Salina Downtown Field House. No one's going to, they'll just put the address, whatever it is, on 5th Street into their GPS, and they'll arrive downtown anyway. The people in South Salina don't need to know it's a downtown field house. The downtown part, to me, is simply a bigger bill for the sign. I think that's all it really accomplishes. I don't think that the downtown businesses are going to reap more sales because the word downtown is on Field House.
But people from outside of Salina will know we have a downtown, because every time they see that poster in Hayes advertising a MABB tournament, oh, it's the downtown. I wonder what else is downtown. They'll know that we have a downtown, and I hope they'll explore.
They'll go downtown because they'll have to go downtown if they're going to our field house. It's not going to be, I don't think it's going to be a big surprise to very many people that we have a downtown. I think that that once they get to the field house, it's going to be a, you know, oh good, okay, you know, we're close to restaurants now. Let's just walk over, see what's up and down Santa Fe. I don't think that we're going to need to. I don't think that adding the word downtown gets more people to eat at Martinelli's. I don't think at all. I don't think that's going to happen. I think people, if they're going to the field house, they're going to either stay downtown to eat, or they're going to find some other place to eat, and they'll probably put the name of the restaurant in their GPS to go there too. People will do what they want to do with or without that name in the as part of the name on the building.
Well, I'll just kind of go back with Dr. Davis here on the it's a branding issue. It's not a, you know, we didn't. I mean, you can say now that you don't want the $30,000 spent, but last week two weeks ago when you didn't want it, that wasn't a consideration. So that, I think that's more of convenience. But if we really want to distill this down, why don't we just call it the Field House? Because everybody,
$60,000.
Everybody knows. Everybody knows
yeah,
where.
That's right.
Everybody knows it's in Salina. Why bother putting Salina on it? You know, it's kind of one of those things where I think what you're missing in the argument is the fact that we're talking about it's an ability to brand something and to sort of put a spotlight on a whole lot of other effort that's going on there. And, you know, we just voted $175,000 for facade improvements that we think will make it look better. This is a branding type of thing that I think we would help to brand it better. And so I don't think anybody's, wants to just spend $30,000 for nothing. I think there is a return on it.
How long would it take to have votes are, so maybe we could dispatch this.
And Marilyn.
I don't, you know, it bothers me that five people get to, that are deciding this thing when it's a, this, we're looking for, we're talking about branding, we're talking about marketing, none of us are marketing experts, none of us are branding experts, and yet we're willing to go out and spend $30,000 on something, I know, it's convenient. On something that may or may not make a difference. It's sort of like on those big highway signs, we were asked, which font do you like the best? I don't want to decide that. I want the people that know that science to decide that.
Yeah. Well, I think that's right.
And so I think the same thing applies to the naming of the Field House.
Well, should we get take a week and or 2 weeks and get the opinion of
no.
people who do this
no.
professionally?
Commissioners, I'd recommend you don't do that.
Thank you.
I think... Naming is not as easy as it should be. It's the least impactful thing you'll have to do with this Field House, period, as far as technical impact. It really doesn't have much. And a staff recommendation would be for you to make a decision this evening on what you want to do with naming, and so we can move on to other things.
Mayor, if I may, just a point of clarification. Am I correct that there is not a motion before you at this point in time?
There is. I made a motion.
There is. I'm sorry. And the motion was consistent with the resolution,
correct.
And that is the Salina
Field House.
Okay,
right.
I'm sorry. I just wanted
okay,
to be sure we were on the same
bring
page.
This
maybe you need an amendment.
The thing that I, well, the reason I raised that, depending on where you want to go with this, we don't want to find ourselves in the same procedural dilemma that, if there is sentiment to want to at least consider the insertion of downtown, then that would most appropriately take the form of a motion to amend the pending motion.
Good point. I will make a motion to amend the motion to add, once again, downtown into the name so that the full municipal title would be Salina Downtown Field House.
Second.
I have a motion and a second to pass... amend the motion to Salina Downtown Field House. All those in favor say aye.
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 Those opposed, same sign.
No.
Aye. So we have 3-2 vote on that.
So the motion is, this will seem a little redundant, but the motion is back before you in its amended form
right.
for
okay.
consideration.
Okay. So the motion now is... to name this Field House, Salina Field House. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Is that what I need to do? I'm sorry.
Well, the amended motion, as I understand, would include downtown. It would be
on that one.
We voted on that one.
That's what I was saying, Mayor. The motion to amend passed.
Motion to amend failed.
Failed.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
2-3. 3-2.
Mm-hmm.
Failed.
I'm sorry.
Maybe there was some confusion.
I have to admit,
I
do need a roll call.
I wasn't sure I heard it right either. So just to be clear then, you had two votes in the affirmative to make the amendment and three votes against the amendment?
Correct.
And the amendment failed. Okay, so you are back then. Yeah, you are back to Salina Field House.
I apologize.
Now we're back to Salina Field House.
I wasn't sure either, so thank you for the clarification.
My fault.
Oh, hey, I would have jumped at it, trust me.
Yeah.
Okay, now where am I? Forgotten.
I'm
back to a motion made by Commissioner Hardy and seconded by, who seconded that?
Seconded it.
Okay,
by
Commissioner Ryan to name at Salina Fieldhouse. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. And those opposed, same sign.
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. That's 3-2 passed. Okay. I acquiesced because it was going to cost us at least $30,000 plus more on brochures. Okay. Okay, now where are we? Do other business? No, we're back down to. No, we're not
now
there
we're
yet.
To the
are
hospital.
We're back
we're
down
in the weeds.
To, now we're back. To, yes, we are.
Part two.
You have two other actions associated with the naming.
Right.
Again, if you desire, you can finish the exterior name of the building, or you can go inside with the package of interior names. Those are the two choices that you have. You split it, I think, three ways: the two parts of the exterior naming, and then packaging up the interior naming.
Mayor's pleasure. I think we would want to do the outside.
Outside, probably.
Outside,
yeah.
Same logic
probably.
John had
yeah,
before.
I think
yeah.
so, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And Commissioner Davis is out.
Oh, and Commissioner Davis is out.
He will recuse
himself. Himself.
Take a walk.
Commissioner Davis has recused himself.
I'll need a break pretty soon.
Okay. Okay. Commissioners, we need to decide what we're going to do here with the major donors.
Well, we didn't have trouble with this before, so if we could have some conversation before the motion. Is everybody still comfortable with Salina Regional Health Center? That seems wordy to me, but that's the way it was proposed in the original motion.
Well, I had made the comments during the debate last time prior to making the amendment to the motion that I had wished all along that this would have been done in the proper manner. And I would very much desire to see Salina Regional recognized in a substantial way, but also in the course of a 50-50 partnership. And with the comments made at the last meeting, I think that the largest contributor to this is the Salina taxpayer. I would love to see Salina Fieldhouse on the exterior of the building and all of the donors recognized in whatever their varying degree of recognition would be on the interior. So I think, not to divide the question any further, but I do think that I do agree with the philanthropic naming. I just don't agree with the entire facility philanthropic naming. I would prefer to see that take place on the interior of the building, and whether that's on a plaque or whether that's on a naming of the full arena and the separate courts, I don't have a problem either way that goes. But that would be my preference.
I agree with those comments too. I don't know, maybe there's another part of the building that we have not considered as well. Like the entrance, for instance, might be an option. I agree that I think Salina Fieldhouse is the proper name for the exterior of the building, mm-hmm. and but I do think that Salina Regional did play an important part in the funding of the building. So
what
they
if we
they did and they also I feel like we're just really so fortunate to have the hospital here in Salina, who have chosen to stay downtown, could have moved someplace else. And also that they provided the impetus to the other givers when they came out with their, I mean, that no doubt gave the other people who wanted to give the impetus to give by giving the $1.3 million, I think it was. Anyway, I'll acquiesce to whatever the rest of the commission wants to do, but I think we could put, I don't really want to see the hospital put on the outside, because I think people drive up to it thinking they're at the hospital. So I think SRHC with their logo and other partners would be good.
On the exterior?
On the exterior.
Well,
SRHC is what.
I hate to be the kind of person that doesn't acknowledge a gift, and I just think we can find some common ground here to both honor what the hospital did and in the manner that they expected. I think the name Salina Regia Health Center is too long, so my thought is shorten that to SRHC with a logo. And if you wanted other community recognition, you could put community partnership or something in there as part of that name. That would recognize that the city had the taxpayers had a big hand in it as well.
I have written down here SRHC and partners, or that would be for other partners, whatever.
Commissioners, I have a question for you that doesn't necessarily apply to this request, but in a way it does, but it really applies to what would be future requests. And that is the foundation, what you just talked about, had to do with the amount of the dollars that it would take to, in essence, name the actual facility and put the name on the outside of the building. What is your expectation about the value, if you want to compare the contribution to the value of the project that you would expect, whether now or in the future, for naming of a building? As you know, Spectra has been tasked for some time to obtain, if they can, naming rights. It would provide some positive financial impact for the Bicentennial Center. And so there's a decent possibility that in the next few months, I would say, they may be bringing a recommendation to you. But I think I wouldn't want to mislead any potential entity that would like to see their name up there with regards to a percentage. If they offer up so much and we're negotiating towards a target and we find out that falls well short of what your expectation might be. So we really do need to know what your expectation would be to name a facility if there is a threshold contribution that you're looking for.
So you're saying this group gave us 10 to 12% of the total building cost and we don't want to put their name on the front. How do we compare that to the Bicentennial Center
I think
situation?
Whatever you do, you want to be consistent with future naming as well. And so what I'm asking for is if 1.25 of, you can call it 10.5, you can call it more if you want because of the new markets, whatever ratio you want to look at, it's not really probably terribly relevant, but whatever that ratio is, if that's not significant enough, what ratio are you really looking for? Because I need to know that, because Spectra is out looking and talking with folks as it relates to the Bicentennial Center. And I don't want to mislead them if they get, spend a lot of time and effort going down those the lines of conversation, and all of a sudden the dollar amount doesn't match up with what the expectation might be.
Yeah.
I just think it's important to be clear.
I'm not really looking at dollar amount, which is kind of strange. I'm looking at how long the name is, and I'm thinking in the case of the Bicentennial Center, if we called it the Pepsi Center, that's okay. Because and you need to get $1 million over 10 years or whatever, because you got the Sprint Center, you got all the arenas with that kind of name, and they're short and sweet and to the point. And I think that the same thing should apply to the Field House as well.
Let me take a different approach to that, because I've given that considerable thought as well. First of all, I'm going to separate the two and just say that I certainly hope and trust that we're handling this process in a whole lot different manner, because technically, in order for this to kind of be philanthropic in the way that that it's being asked to be, this process needed to start a long time ago, before we started even drawing up plans, floor plans. So I mean, and also the fact of public-private partnerships are different. But let me throw in like one example. And I'll tie in the Bicentennial Center as well. And that is Salina Community Theater. And the Salina Community Theater is the Salina Community Theater, but they have the Sunflower Stage or Box Theater or whatever, which is a named portion. And it's the Sunflower Theater at the Salina Community Theater. So there's that. And I think there's the opportunity with the Salina Bicentennial Center, and I'll just use Commissioner Hardy's example of Pepsi, that there exists a possibility to have at the Pepsi Arena at the Salina Bicentennial Center. I mean, you have Heritage Hall, and you have we have Budke Court there, and and all those different things. But there's a different feel to that, and I'll just conclude it with when we had our meeting in October of 2014, we sat here and we talked about naming rights. And the discussion was, to anybody that wants to go back, and I had asked Mr. Richardson, who's not here tonight, but I had asked him about the naming rights and also the three-year pledge to be subsidize the operational deficits. And at that October 27, 2014 meeting, the question came up, well, what about the opportunity for naming rights? And I think it was prompted from Commissioner Davis had asked about that three-year pledge. And the conversation, I believe, you had answered in the fashion of, well, you know, we still have the opportunity for naming rights and or sponsorships to help maybe pay some of those, maybe not all of those operating deficits. So part of my, I in no way feel anything but gratitude to Salina Regional for their contribution. This is more about, we weren't asked, hey, do you guys have plans for the naming rights, or do you plan to maybe help offset some of your costs for doing this? Because we had. And so I really think that from the point that place opens, it's going to be a city-owned facility, and it's going to be the taxpayer's responsibility to make sure that it's staffed and that it's maintained, and that when other things need to be fixed and repaired so that it's in tip-top shape so we can continue to market it to groups, that those are going to be placed on the back of the taxpayer. And so this in no way has anything to do with anything other than in this partnership, I'd like to recognize through whatever indoor, and I talked about it last time, the aesthetic and the marketing consistency of how we market this. If we do call it the Salina Regional Health Center Arena or arenas or whatever, I don't know what the proper thing for field houses on the inside is. I'd very much like to do that. And every other donor that had an expectation that would. So the best that we can, I'd like to fulfill the expectations that we did not ourselves make to the donors. But if that makes sense on how we deal with it down the road, I think that we have a procedure that we need to follow down the road that will safeguard us from having bumps in the road, but also that, you know what, we don't, I'm like Commissioner Hardy, I don't have a dollar amount that, or percentage even, as Commissioner Ryan mentioned, I don't have what that dollar amount would be or percentage wise or whatever, but just the thought that it's like if we're receiving year over year revenues to help offset some costs, and that's what the sponsorships and I anticipate maybe the naming rights will help do with the Bicentennial Center.
Okay, we have to determine what we're going to do here. Do I have a motion?
Are there other options in the structure?
I don't know. I think depending on what you do, we're going to have to go back and make the naming of the outside of the facility ineligible because you took an eligibility action not long ago, knowing that we're looking at the outside and the inside. So in all honesty, if you depending on what you do, if it's your intent for whatever reason not to name the outside anything other than a municipal name, which is fine, we're going to have, I think we need to go back. We'll have to bring that back and have you revisit that piece just because we need to make it, that piece is to decide if you want to name the building. And in this case, you had a package. You didn't have just a single name. I get that. I think we would want to clarify that if you choose not to wish to name the outside after anyone, any entity, just to be clear. But you have all the options. I mean, you what you have is a request. You can do whatever you want. You can turn it all down. You can approve it as you wish. You can chop it up. It's totally up to you. It's your authority on what you want to do with that and what you think is appropriate.
Did you have a motion?
I had not made a motion on this aspect of this.
Oh,
I guess I'd like to see the philanthropic gift recognized on the front of the building as they were asked. Maybe it does make some sense to consider these things anew down the road, but in this case, I think we ought to follow through. If we maybe we could shorten the entire description in the front as Salina Regional Health Center, SRHC, and the logo, and leave it at that.
I'll second it. Is that a motion?
I'll make that a motion.
I'll second it. Okay, got a motion and a second to a proposal to put SRHC and the logo on the outside. Is that right?
Yep.
Okay. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those against?
No. Aye.
There we are.
Well, I guess you'll just have to send that back.
We'll just have to send it back.
Well, are you referring to the comment that Mr. Gage made concerning eligibility?
Yeah, I don't see anything to send back. You still need to deal with the package of internal names. But the question of eligibility is I think we need to be very...
They followed all the procedures here.
Yeah. Yeah, I just think that the action you had taken before was to make the facility eligible for naming. Now, at that point, you kind of took a total action on the full facility. If it's your choice not to name the outside after anyone, then I think you want to go back and you need to modify that action at that point to, in essence, make sure that on record it shows that you're not interested in naming the outside of the facility so that it's not left open for another name.
So it doesn't come up again for someone else?
Absolutely.
Okay, yeah,
yeah,
I see.
That's to make it clear for the future so that if Westar or Great Plains or whomever, sorry, that's not eligible for naming, period.
Right, and I think that's important.
Yeah.
I think that would be an important, very important step.
I wouldn't want to lay that on future commissions, and at a different point in time somebody may want.
Well, then they can vote at that time.
Offer a big enough incentive.
Then I think that they can make that determination at that time to say it is eligible. But I think if we're going to sit here and say it ought to be just a municipal naming right, then I think we don't leave the door open, as city manager says. I think we need to close that door and just say nobody else is going to come in and for whatever reason. I can't imagine what that might be. But I think, what do we need to do to get that on a future agenda? Just ask staff to...
Well, if that's your intent, I'll just bring it back and you can vote.
Okay.
You can, a future commission can always reverse you later. It's not something that's static in perpetuity. It's just, if that's the intent of this body, then I think the eligibility needs to be clear about it. A future commission can change the eligibility anytime they want. I don't want to send a mixed message to either Salina Regional or to any other entity about the naming of the outside. That's
right.
Why I'm bringing that up. It's up to you. If you don't want it back, we don't have to bring it back, but then technically it's technically eligible for renaming on the outside. That's really up to you. I just think that you want it clean, whatever you do.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The procedures were all followed, so I think we should probably be doing that, but we can't come to an agreement on that, then we need to proceed forward in whatever manner you deem proper.
Yeah. So I can bring that back to you and you can decide what you want to do with it. For tonight, you still have the package of internal naming,
mm-hmm.
inside
right.
spaces.
Would somebody get Commissioner Davis? Is he eligible for this?
He would be, yes.
Let me just ask Dave.
He'd be eligible for this, I think.
If it includes, as I said earlier, if it would include them, Salina Regional on the interior, not exclusively, but along with every other entity, with that?
Yeah, anytime there is a Salina Regional Health Center aspect, he would be disqualified.
Okay.
The other thing Well.
Then probably he shouldn't come back for this item either then. Okay.
The only other thing I thought about in conjunction with that was to have some sort of plaque or monument on the exterior, on the grounds somewhere close to the entrance, say, that would express acknowledgement of Salina Regional participation.
I would just like to see, I mean, I don't know, maybe I've overlooked it, but I'd like to see exactly how, like, reports. I think I saw them once before, but I never did find out, or I never do remember seeing if there was anything as you come in the door. You know, there usually is in these places. And I mean, if we aren't going to put it on the outside, we sure should have it right at the very first thing people see when they enter.
Well, I think that was an intention, but that our report isn't that descriptive. Mm-hmm. To go into the detail of how each court would be labeled and size of the sign and the fonts and
those
things.
Yeah, but what I think the mayor might be referring to is that an honorary plaque or something a little more formal.
I've seen where there's lettering all the way across the lobby. Yes, and I think that would be I would take that. That's what I would do. Yeah.
Commissioner, I don't know that someone would see something as they enter, but you do have a name for the lobby, a name for the concourse, a name for the concession area, and then a name for each of the north and south gyms and each of the food courts in those. So those are the spaces that are named. So wherever you put, if you want to put a name somewhere else, you can do that. I'm not sure. You'd have to think about what you want to attribute it to. But those things are all currently taken up unless you, again, should choose to shuffle.
Seems to me where we're stuck is that when we take the name off the front, then we have to redo everything on the inside. So we're stuck.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't recommend shuffling because I don't see a lot of positive that's going to come out of it. I wouldn't change any of that. You theoretically, I suppose, could have an entry plaza. You don't have that. I don't. It's not a large plaza area. You don't have to go too far before you're into what I'd call the lobby and concourse area, but technically speaking, you could have an entry plaza, I suppose. And then we would have to then think about what that means, where a name could be as far as the building design. We don't know that right now. You'd have to ask us to check. We'd go back and check and see, make sure we could do that. I think also, too, with that suggestion, I think you would, not necessarily tonight, it could be, or at some point before we move forward to see if the donor wishes or is agreeable to that. I think that would be nice to know as well. But assuming that to be the case, that's the option that I can think of.
Sounds like there are a number of combinations there, and I think it would be prudent to find out, since there is a need for a reconfiguration, maybe what the donors in consultation with the fundraisers, and hopefully we can get a member of Parks and Rec staff involved with that as well, to kind of help facilitate maybe what that reconfigured look might be. So if it's appropriate, I would move that we postpone the philanthropic interior naming of, can we do this till the next meeting and give those folks an opportunity? Would that be enough time to staff?
We have a meeting next week.
We have a meeting next week, but then not the following 24th we have.
And there's really not a rush.
I mean, if we make the decision tonight, we may not know that.
Yeah,
it
could
be.
Couldn't it?
Yeah.
There's
not a rush, I don't think.
Yeah, well, whatever's appropriate.
Whatever amount of time.
Whatever an appropriate time frame may be to figure that.
And I'm sorry, I missed part of that, but it would be to emphasize the entry or another area?
No. Yeah, well, that may be it, but I think just to say, there would be a reconfiguration of sorts, I would assume, of some of that philanthropic naming. Or maybe it's an addition as to an entry plaza in recognition or something like that. I don't know what that might be, and I don't think we're in a position to say this is what it ought to be, because we don't know what the expectations of the people that on the interior, that I think probably everybody's in agreement with. Does that make sense?
I think so. I think one thing that we need to know for sure, though, before we can carry that out, is are you saying that it would be your expectation still to potentially shuffle names in assigned interior spaces?
I think what I'm hearing Commissioner Blanchard say is that we're stuck. on a philanthropic naming of the front of the building, and so we'd like them to consider how they'd like to have it done, given that fact.
Well, what we, how about this? How about if we were to take action on approving philanthropic naming rates on the interior of the building and potential adjacent plaza area. I'm assuming a plaza is an exterior. Was an exterior that someone.
Yeah.
In the form of whatever
plaza. Spaces better, I think. I'll look at Greg to see if he concurs, but I think you could have a motion to approve the recommended interior names for those spaces, and at the same time request that staff look for space options to recognize Salina Regional's contribution.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Good.
Is that what you're after?
Yes.
Is that motion, would that be suitable, Greg?
Do you want to make that motion?
Okay, that's my motion.
Whatever
so
it was he
I'll
said.
Second.
To do.
Okay, I have a motion and a second, and I'm not going to try to say that over again. All those in favor say aye.
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 Aye. Those opposed, same sign. Okay. And now we have a executive meeting, I think.
Sorry for all that.
Yeah, commissioners, I'm sorry, on the next item on the executive session, we will ask that you add property acquisition or real estate, I think is the formal title, and that add that language to your motion in addition to the legal, please.
Where did
is shall we bring?
Yeah,
yeah.
He's
where
coming.
Is he?
Back.
Yeah.
Okay.
For the public's benefit, we will not expect to come out and take any further action in it. So we don't expect to have any follow-up action at all after the executive session.
Legal.
Yeah, your agenda shows an executive session for legal. We are asking that you add the real estate topic as well in the motion to include the language for both of those topics in the motion. For a time, you're probably looking for a time, aren't you, as well? I'm going to be really optimistic. Optimistic would be 45 minutes. I call that exceptionally
that
optimistic.
That would be pretty optimistic.
Wow.
About
that's
an hour.
Good.
That's pretty optimistic still.
An hour.
Okay. Madam Mayor, move to recess into executive session for 60 minutes to discuss with legal counsel matters subject to the attorney-client privilege for the reason that public discussion of those matters would waive the privilege and adversely affect the city's interest in the matters, and to discuss matters pertaining to the acquisition of real estate for the reason that public discussion of the matter would adversely affect the city's position in relation to acquisition of the real estate, and reconvene at 6:35 p.m.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion and a second to adjourn for into executive session until 6:35. All those in favor say aye.
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 Aye. Opposed, same sign. We are adjourned.